Godzilla vs. Mothra. Originally conceived as a standalone Mothra film entitled Mothra vs. Bogon, the movie was notable for its return to a more fantasy-based, family-oriented atmosphere evocative of pre-1984 Godzilla films. Although he did not return as director, Amori continued his trend of incorporating Hollywood elements into his screenplay, in this case nods to the Indiana Jones franchise. The film was released in Japan on December 12, 1992 and in direct-to-video in the United States in 1998 by Columbia TriStar Home Video as Godzilla and Mothra: The Battle for Earth. Unadjusted for inflation, the film remains the highest-grossing film of the Toho Godzilla films and was the second highest-grossing film in Japan in 1993, second only to Jurassic Park. In mid-1992, following the events of the previous film, a meteoroid lands in the Agasawara Trench and awakens Godzilla. 6 months later, explorer Takuya Fujita was detained after stealing an ancient artifact. Later, a representative of the Japanese Prime Minister offers to have Takuya's charges dropped if he explores Infant Island with his ex-wife, Masako Tezuka and Kenji Ando, the secretary of the rapacious Maritomo Company. After the trio arrives on the island, they find a cave containing a depiction of two giant insects in battle. Further exploration leads them to a giant egg and a pair of diminutive humanoids called Cosmos, who identify the egg as belonging to Mothra. The Cosmos tell of an ancient civilization that tried to control the Earth's climate, thus provoking the Earth into creating Mothra, which became uncontrollable, and started to harm the very planet that created it. Mothra, another Earth protector, fought an apocalyptic battle with Mothra, who eventually lost. The Cosmos explain how the meteoroid uncovered Mothra's egg, and may have awoken Mothra, who is still embittered over humanity's interference in the Earth's natural order. The Maritomo Company sends a freighter to Infant Island to pick up the egg, ostensibly to protect it. As they are sailing, Godzilla surfaces and heads towards newly hatched Mothra larva. Mothra, also as a larva, soon appears and joins the fight, allowing Mothra to retreat. The battle between Godzilla and Mothra is eventually taken underwater, where the force of the battle causes a giant crack in the ocean's floor that swallows the two. Masako and Takuya later discover Ando's true intentions when he kidnaps the Cosmos and takes them to Maritomo headquarters, where the CEO intends to house them for publicity purposes. Mothra enters Tokyo in an attempt to rescue the Cosmos, but is attacked by the JSDF. The wounded Mothra heads for the Diet building and starts building a cocoon around herself. Meanwhile, Godzilla surfaces from Mount Fuji. Both Mothra and Mothra attain their Imago forms and converge at Yokohama Cosmo World. Godzilla interrupts the battle and attacks Mothra. The two moths decide to join forces against Godzilla. Eventually, Mothra and Mothra overwhelm Godzilla and carry it over the ocean. Godzilla bites Mothra's neck and fires its atomic breath into the wound, killing Mothra. A tired Mothra drops Godzilla and the lifeless Mothra into the water below, sealing Godzilla below the surface by creating a mystical glyph with scales from her wings. The next morning, the Cosmos explain that Mothra had been waiting many years to destroy an even larger meteoroid that would threaten the Earth in 1999. Mothra had promised she would stop the future collision if Mothra were to die, and she and the Cosmos leave Earth as the humans bid farewell. The idea of shooting a movie featuring a revamped Mothra dated back to a screenplay written in 1990 by Akira Murao entitled Mothra vs. Bogon, which revolved around a vengeful dragon called Bogon who sought to destroy humanity for its abuse of the Earth's resources, only to be defeated by Mothra, the goddess of peace. The screenplay was revised by Kazuki Amori after the release of Godzilla vs. Biollante, though the project was ultimately scrapped by Toho, under the assumption that Mothra was a character born purely out of Japanese culture, and thus would have been difficult to market overseas unlike the more internationally recognized Godzilla. After the success of Godzilla vs. King Ghidorah, producer Shogo Tomiyama and Godzilla series creator Tomoyuki Tanaka proposed resurrecting King Ghidorah in a film entitled Ghidorah's Counterattack, but relented when polls demonstrated that Mothra was more popular with women, who comprised the majority of Japan's population. Tomiyama replaced Amori with Takao Okawara as director, but maintained Amori as screenwriter. Hoping to maintain as much of Mothra vs. Bogon as possible, Amori reconceptualized Bogon as Badora, a dark twin to Mothra. The character was later renamed Mothra, a portmanteau of battle and Mothra, as the first name was disharmonious in Japanese. Tomiyama had intended to feature Mothra star Frankie Sakai, but was unable to because of scheduling conflicts. The final battle between Godzilla, Mothra and Mitra was originally meant to have a more elaborate conclusion, as in the final product, Godzilla would have been transported to sea, only to kill Mitra and plunge into the ocean. However, the site of their fall would have been the submerged, Stonehenge-like ruins of the cosmos civilization, which would have engulfed and trapped Godzilla with a force field activated by Mothra. Eiichiro Honda, who directed the first Godzilla film and many others, visited the set shortly before dying. Koichi Kawakata continued his theme of giving Godzilla's opponents the ability to metamorphose, and had initially intended to have Mothra killed off, only to be reborn as the cybernetic moth Mechamothra, though this was scrapped early in production, thus making Godzilla vs. Mothra the first post-1984 Godzilla movie to not feature a mecha contraption. The underwater scenes were filmed through an aquarium filled with fish set between the performers and the camera. Kawakata's team constructed a new Godzilla suit from previously used molds, though it was made slimmer than previous suits, the neck given more prominent ribbing, and the arrangement of the character's dorsal plates was changed so that the largest plate was placid on the middle of the back. The arms were more flexible at the biceps, and the face was given numerous cosmetic changes, the forehead was reduced and flattened, the teeth scaled down, and the eyes given a golden tint. The head was also electronically modified to allow more vertical mobility. Filming the Godzilla scenes was hampered when the suit previously used for Godzilla vs. Biollante and Godzilla vs. King Ghidorah, which was needed for some stunt work, was stolen from Toho Studios, only to be recovered at Lake Hokutama in bad condition. The remains of the suit were recycled for the first battle sequence. Godzilla's roar was reverted to the high-pitched shriek from pre-1984 Godzilla films, while Batra's sound effects were recycled from those of Rodan. In designing Batra, which the script described as a black Mothra, artist Shinji Nishikawa sought to distance its design from Mothra's by making its adult form more similar to its larval one than is the case with Mothra, and combining Mothra's two eyes into one. Godzilla vs. Mothra was released in Japan on December 12, 1992, where it was distributed by Toho. The film sold approximately 4,200,000 tickets in Japan, becoming the number one Japanese film on the domestic market in the period that included the year 1993. It made 2.22 billion yen in distribution income. The film was released in the United States as Godzilla and Mothra: The Battle for Earth on April 28, 1998 on home video by Columbia TriStar Home Video. Review aggregation website Rotten Tomatoes has a 67% approval rating from critics, based on 6 reviews with an average score of 5.5. Edgar Zasefsky of Monster Zero said, "Rushed into production but a few months after Godzilla vs. King Ghidorah, this film is unable to hide its hurried nature, but, effects-wise, the film makes up for the story shortcomings and then some." Japan Hero said, "While this movie is not the best of the Heisei series, it is still a really interesting movie. The battles are cool, and Batra was an interesting idea. If you have never seen this movie, I highly recommend it." Stomp Tokyo said the film is one of the better Godzilla movies and that the scenes in which monsters do not appear actually make some sort of sense. And for once, they are acted with some gusto, so that we as viewers can actually come to like the characters on screen, or at least be entertained by them. Mike Bogue of American Kaiju said the film does not live up to its potential, but added that its colorful and elaborate spectacle eventually won him over, and the main story thread dealing with the eventual reconciliation of the divorced couple adequately holds the human plot together. Sony, Blu-ray, Toho Godzilla Collection. Thanks for watching. Don't forget like the video and don't forget to subscribe.